If you're looking to use Canva to sell digital products, start a small business, or even do freelance design work, then stick around because in this video, I'll share my 5 licensing terms that might affect how you work and sell in Canva. Now let's dive into the deep end here, my friends, and talk about logos in Canva. Yes, you're allowed to create them. I mean, they have hundreds, if not thousands, of templates to choose from. But don't be fooled, my friends, because logos in Canva are not exclusive and you can't register them as a trademark. Now, if you're anything like me, you're probably asking yourself, why would they even offer an option to make a logo? The short answer is Canva wanted users with no budget or time to have the ability to create something on the fly when they're small enough and don't have to worry about exclusive rights. Now let's move on to the next Canva term, and that's reselling. Let's say you found a template that you really liked and you changed the colors and moved some stuff around, so you're really happy with the results and you want to start selling it. That's great, but unfortunately you can't do that. The reason why is Canva doesn't allow you to resell, redistribute, or even take credit for unaltered media provided through Canva. Now, if you use that template as a blueprint and change the overall design and alter the different elements to around 80 or 90%, then you're good to start selling that template. The key is to always alter the template and elements used in that design. Creating something unique will lower your chances of violating any Canva terms. And that's a good segue into the next term, which is ownership. Now, if you're using a pre-made Canva template and you throw that up on your portfolio or start taking credit for the design, you are in fact violating Canva's terms. Now, when creating almost anything in Canva, you can't display content in a manner that gives the impression that the content was created by you or a person other than the copyright holder. So, in other words, just don't say you created something you got from Canva as your own. That's just a good rule for life in general. Moving on, let's talk about using Canva for client work. Now, if you're freelancing with Canva, that's fine and dandy, but keep in mind that when you pass off your client's work or templates, you will remain solely responsible and liable for your client's compliance with all of Canva's terms. So just to cover yourself and your client, I would suggest you provide Canva's terms along with the final deliverables. That way you and your client are all on the same page. And finally, let's talk about free content licenses in Canva. Now we all know by now Canva gives you a whole bunch of free options to choose from, but when you use any of the free resources, Canva grants you a non-exclusive, non-transferable license to use the free content. If you're not sure an element you're using in Canva falls under free content, simply hover over an asset you want to use and click on the 3 dots. You'll get this pop-up and here you can see it says free. To learn more about the terms, just click on free and Canva will give you more information and details about how you can and can't use that specific asset. Also, if you're using free content from Pixabay or Pexels, you would fall under their terms and services and licensing, so be sure to check out their terms before using them in your next project. With that said, I hope I open your eyes to the legal world of Canva. I know it's not sexy, but it's something that every Canva user should read up on before they start designing. Anyway, if you really want to get lost in the sauce with the terms covered in this video, be sure to check out the links in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching. As always, keep on designing and enjoy the process.